A special roundup on COVID-19. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today held a meeting with the state chief ministers through video conferencing. Modi reviewed country's progress in containing the coronavirus pandemic. They also discussed on further relaxations to boost economic activities. The meeting was also attended by Home Minister Amit Shah, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, Health Minister Harshvardhan and other senior officials. As the country enters into the last week of its third phase of lockdown, Prime Minister's meeting with the state chief ministers is considered to be very crucial in terms of finalising the roadmap ahead. Indian Railways has announced a gradual restart of passenger train services from tomorrow. Initially, 15 pairs of trains will ply with passengers on board. These trains will be run as special trains from New Delhi station connecting Dibrugarh, Agartala, Howrah, Patna, Bilaspur, Ranchi, Bhubaneswar, Secunderabad, Bengaluru, Chennai, Thiruvananthapuram, Margao, Mumbai Central and Ahmedabad. AIR correspondent reports that booking for reservations in these trains started at 4 p.m. today and will be available only on the IRCTC website. Ticket booking counters at the railway stations shall remain closed and counter tickets will not be issued. National Institute of Virology, Pune has developed a first indigenous antibody-based ELISA test kit COVID coverage for diagnosis of novel coronavirus. This test is expected to change the dynamics of COVID-19 testing in the country. The kit has displayed high sensitivity and accuracy in the validation tests at different sites. It can test around 90 samples in approximately 2.5 hours. In a tweet, Union Health Minister Harshvardhan said that ELISA or ELISA-based testing can easily be operated even at district level. He informed that the technology has been transferred to pharmaceutical manufacturing companies for mass-scale production. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal today held an interactive session with various industry associations in Guwahati. Sonowal, in presence of representatives of industry associations, discussed COVID-19 impact on the industries in the state. Various medium and small-scale industries have been affected in the state during this period. Meanwhile, the regional news unit of AIR Guwahati held a series of live quiz for listeners during lockdown. Various organizations, including Assam Police, Government of Assam, Educational and National Health Mission, partnered with AIR in the endeavor. The objective of holding the quiz competition was to keep the listeners engaged in a positive way. Meghalaya Deputy Chief Minister Preston Tinsong today informed that 30,000 people informed that 3,030 people of Meghalaya who were stranded in different parts of the northeastern state have arrived back home. Speaking to media, reports also said that more than 8,000 people who are stranded throughout the country have registered with the government to come back to the state. These people who have registered with the government have to be tested with rapid test kits when they enter the state. According to Tinsong, government have also taken a decision to open retail vegetable markets besides fruits, eggs and fish market. He also said that as of now, 2,480 people in the state have been tested, while 2,342 of them tested negative and samples of 125 tests are awaited. Meghalaya as of now have two active cases. The East Khasi Hills Deputy Commissioner has allowed opening of retail shops for 5 days from May 12 from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., while the wholesale traders of Cantonment, Maulong Hut, Paltan Bazaar, Madanrathing and Happy Valley markets will keep their establishments open for lifting of stocks on Monday. The Deputy Commissioner has also extended night curfew in East Khasi Hills from Monday till May 18 from 7 p.m. to 6 a.m., while there is already a restriction for the movement of people under Section 144 CRPC during the day. Listeners, that was a special roundup on COVID-19 brought to you by the Regional Unit of All India Radio.